Porto shuttle bus les va a colectar a 2:30 a.m.
Oh, that is lovely.
You're very welcome. Another satisfied customer.
Oh, yeah. Who else have you been rubbing with sun cream?
Ah, that's for me to know and you to find out.
It's a joke.
Yeah. Like your dodgy claim for disability, that was for you to know and the DSS to find out, and they bloody did, didn't they?
Yeah, well, it's all sorted now. Not a care in the world.
Not a care in the world? We're up to our eyeballs in debt. We've got an 8-year-old with ADD and a 17-year-old with a 9-month-old baby.
Yeah, well, that's the beauty of an holiday in the sun, isn't it? Forget all your cares and worries. It's like these two, black and white minstrels. Look at the state of them, they couldn't give a shit.
Don't you go upsetting him today.
Don't go upsetting him? He could have an argument in a phone box with no money, that one.
Mind you, he has paid for this holiday.
Oh, Christ, and don't we know about it?
A bit of gratitude won't go amiss. He nearly died in that pool yesterday.
And whose fault was that? Nobody told him to have a diving competition with Fatty Arbuckle. Anyway, it was me that gave him the kiss of life.
I know. It's no wonder he looks so ill. Hiya, Mum. Hiya, Mel. How are you feeling?
Lucky to be alive.
Yeah.
But I'd rather not talk about it. It's all the same to you.
We had a terrible night.
Madge ran me a bath and I started having flashbacks. I think it was the sound of the water. But to be honest, I'd rather not talk about it.
Probably best if you don't.
You on the old karaoke tonight, Mel?
It's terrible when your whole life flashes in front of you like that. I couldn't even see it properly because I didn't have my glasses on. Still, I'd rather just forget about it. It's all the same to you.
Yeah, we could deal with that, no problem.
Can I get you a drink, Mel?
I still feel the chlorine in the water ravaging my eyes.
Oh, for fuck's sake!
What's wrong with him?
Oh, we knew you'd be back, the pair of you, didn't we, Jacqueline?
Oh, yeah.
Well, actually, it's a belated honeymoon.
Oh, lovely. Because this is where you proposed, isn't it?
Yes. We've returned to the scene of the crime.
How romantic.
Yeah.
Plus 160 quid all-inclusive for a week. Cost more to stay at home.
Oh, exactly. We've got a friend at our sauna, Big Donna. She's been banned from most of the all-you-can-eat restaurants in our area, hasn't she?
She's a big girl.
But she comes to Benidorm and they just let her get on with it here, don't they?
It's buffet heaven. She even got caught smuggling pancake rolls in her knickers from Mr. Woo's, but they just gave her a doggy bag.
It's as if we never left.
You're shaking him too much. You're going to make him puke.
Michael, I won't tell you again.
He's giving me a headache.
We'll go somewhere else then.
I want to stay with you.
Well, then stop asking stupid questions.
Why did you have a baby?
What have I just said to you?
Well, that's not a stupid question. Why did you have a baby?
Because I just did.
You think Nana and Mel will have a baby?
No, I don't.
Why not?
Because they're too old.
I wish they would have one.
Why?
Because then we'd have a brown baby and an orange one as well.
Oh, hello there. What's wrong with you?
Can I pick him up?
Yeah. Do you want to look after him tonight?
Hello, my name's Kate.
Hiya, do you want to look after him tonight?
Do you really think it's wise to be asking someone you don't know to babysit for you?
Well, I know who you are. You were here last year when our Michael dropped a log in the pool.
Sorry.
What's your baby's name?
Coolio.
Coolio?
After the rapper.
Oh, I see. I don't think I know any of his songs.
Gangster's Paradise. Sticky Fingers. Ugly bitches.
No.
Hello.
Hiya.
Just spoken to the hotel in Altea and they said they might be able to have us back tomorrow. So looks like we're stuck here for a bit longer. Well, at least tonight. I'm sure we can find something to do.
Mum, on that scooter, we can find you another sunbed.
I'm all right on here, thank you. Got everything I need here.
You're all right, Mel?
I'll survive.
Might be nice for Mel to use the wheelchair for a couple of days while he's not feeling too good.
Thicker dum-dum, a great balls of fire.
You what?
Karaoke for tonight.
Here we are, fill your boots.
I might have a crack at Wuthery Heights.
Yeah? I'll look forward to that.
Hey, you and Telle should do a duet. What about Ebony and Ivory?
Why don't we have a nice night in together? You should be taking it easy.
Well, with karaoke on the go, no danger.
Here we are, Madge. This round's on me.
I think you'll find the drinks are on Mel. It's all inclusive.
A little change from 900 quid for this holiday. Not have much thanks for it.
What's that you're talking about? Me saving your life yesterday? Oh, no, don't mention it.
Cheers, Mel.
Oh, you won't get any thanks out of that one.
I just said thank you.
I've never understood that selfish, ungrateful streak in my kids.
I said thank you.
When she was a child, she used to eat her sweets on the toilet so she didn't have to share them with anyone.
Now, do you actually believe this stuff yourself, Mother, or do you just enjoy making it up as you go along?
Hiya.
What do you want?
Just want to see if you were all right after yesterday.
I'm fine, no thanks to you.
Beg your pardon?
You heard me. If it hadn't been for you, I wouldn't have banged my head on the bottom of the pool.
Well, how'd you work that out?
You've done enough damage. Why can't you leave the man in peace?
Leave him in peace?
It's idiots like you get people killed.
Are you calling an idiot, you dickhead?
All right, ladies, that's enough.
Dickhead? Dickhead? You can't talk to me like that. My father fell at Normandy.
I don't care if you went arse over tits in Scunthorpe, you're a dickhead.
Can we just all calm down?
Think yourself lucky. You should be up for attempted murder.
Fuck off.
Right, that's it.
Mel,
come here.
Come on.
Yeah.
See you move. Yeah, no, go on.
Mel, what are you doing? Sit there.
Come on, Normandy. Get off me.
Break it up now. Joe, fat boy, you caused problems here before. I remember. Up.
Yeah. Well, keep away from me, do you? Keep away!
On your bike.
And that goes for two-shared turtle, wheelchair and all.
Go with your mammy.
I'm going. Dickheads.
Who the frig's Touche Turtle?
Martin, turn the television off. We can't have that on with the baby here.
Why not? We might like it.
Martin, please don't try to be funny. It's very tiring. And close the balcony door. There's a draft.
That'll be the baby then.
Put some proper shoes on. Hello, come in. Hiya. Right. It's got a bottle in the front pocket. If that runs out, there's some powdered stuff in the bag. It's got two dummies in the side zip pocket. If you drop them on the floor, put them in boiling water. If he cries, he's got a teething ring in the inside pocket. I shouldn't be too late. Wet wipes are in bottom of the bag. Hiya.
Right. Okay. Anything else?
No, that's it. Oh, and I think he might need changing. Thanks a lot. I'll see you later.
Is it all right to open the balcony door again?
How's your chicken, ma'am?
A bit bland. Wish I'd gone for the beef curtains.
Beef medallions, ma'am. Do you mind?
Beef curtains!
You knew what she meant.
Oh, Jesus. Who needs cabaret when your mother sat there?
You're up. Hiya, love. Did you get him sorted?
Yeah, they were dead chuffed to have him.
Oh, lovely. It's only for a couple of hours, isn't it?
Yeah. Where's Mel?
He'll be here soon. He was getting changed.
Does smell like beef curtains, mate.
Will you pack it in?
What are beef curtains?
Now look what you've done. Oh, my God.
Everyone all right for drinks? Walking orange, Madge?
No, I'm fine, thank you.
Back in a minute.
Jesus, looks like we're getting cabaret after all.
Well, hello, Saturday Night Fever.
Is that the bloke that was wearing the thong yesterday?
Yes, yeah, quite a natty dresser.
I've got a swimsuit with a thong. It's very summery, but it can ride up a bit, if you know what I mean.
Excuse me, could you cancel my order for the blancmange?
Superman! Digging in the fast lane! Listen to the countdown! They're playing our song again! I can't get jump jack, just wanna hold my moonlight! Use that thing that funny rock talk about! Pop music!
He won't stop.
Yes, I have noticed.
Well, don't just stand there. Do something. What on earth are you doing?
I'm dancing.
Why on earth do you think a 9-month-old baby would want to...
He likes it.
Well, don't stop.
He's actually not a bad mover.
Right. It might help us if you define the word bad.
You need everybody talk about pop music, talk about pop music, talk about pop music, pop, pop, pop music.
It's quite sexy in some ways, isn't it?
Talk about.
I'm sorry, are we all looking at the same thing?
Don't get me wrong. He's not conventionally attractive, but I have been known to go for some unusual types in my time.
You don't say.
I'm getting tired. Can you take over?
I can't do that.
Of course you can. It's all in the hips.
It's no good, he likes it when you dance. Martin, what's he doing? Martin, don't pick him up. He likes your dancing. It's not your dancing. He likes you.
Dedicate this to a very special lady who over the last few weeks has made me feel like a very special man.
Mistake, do you, Madge?
Lonely boy loves you. I'm sorry to interrupt, but I just wanted to apologise for my son having a go at your husband today.
Oh, he's not my husband. He's just a friend. Well, an acquaintance, really. Hardly know him.
Oh, right. I just didn't want it to spoil your holiday.
No, don't be daft. It was just a misunderstanding.
Well, it can get a bit out of control. When he was little, he had one of them leather crash helmets, you know, to stop him nutting the wall. But it don't fit him anymore. Well, they grow so fast, don't they? Baby.
Lonely girl. Don't you know this lonely boy?
Just before I hand the mic back, there's a small announcement I'd like to make. As some of you know, yesterday I had an accident in the pool which nearly took my life. It's times like this that make you realise that life is not a rehearsal. This is it. And yes, I have made a success of my life. I've got 5 sunbed shops in Manchester. But I think it was Charles Manson who said, "You're not living life to the full if you're living it alone." I know my late wife, Neris, who died in a crazy paving accident in 1979, will be smiling down on me now as I say, "Madge, Delilah Barron, will you marry me?"
Fucking hell!
There are mountains
in our way. But we clung.
Yes.
Yes, I'll marry it.